here. Quick look at the European market for April the 20th, 2010. Welcome to FX Bootcamp. Quick reminder, non-alert service. Not going to make any trade recommendations during the course of a day, but what I will do is conduct some live fundamental and technical analysis. With a bit of luck, we can put together some good positive trade plans. Please bear in mind that trading heavily leveraged is always risky business, particularly when you leverage at 100 to 1, sometimes more. Occasionally, as a novice, this leverage work for you. Unfortunately, more times than not, it's going to work against you, so I encourage you not to trade your hard-earned money until you have a good proven track record of success using your broker's demo. Alright guys, well there's the admin note out the way. Please remember, please join me on my new Twitter account, Forex David. That's where you're going to find me. I'll just search David Pegler. I do pretty much live updates as I see the market during the course of the day, so maybe that's of some benefit to you, and come and join the community. Alright, this is a Euro-Yen chart. I figured I'd look at Euro-Yen and maybe some cable and call it good. All of the yens are very much in the same boat, so when I'm talking about the Euro-Yen, I'm really talking about all of the yens in general. The one challenge I'm having with the yens at the moment is not trading them intraday or trading them even, you know, on a swing trading type basis. It's just reconciling the long-term analysis with what the equity markets are doing, which is proving the challenge. You're getting a few mixed signals here and there given the relative bullishness of the equity market, even though I'm tremendously bearish on it. Alright, so this is Euro Yen, and I'm all the way out to a weekly chart here, and you don't have to be a rocket scientist to see that this has been a critical area. You know, let's call it 127 to 128 area. Absolutely important, right? I mean, previous swing lows, if I grab the Fib, the drop, you know, it's a resistance area. I'm not going to do it. But you can just see that this is what looks to be a 382. If you take it from this drop, looks like a 50%. And if that's the case, you know, you're thinking further down here. So this is really what it boils down to in a nutshell is on Euro-Yen is, right, are we doing this? Okay, you know, a little sort of continuation flag pattern, in which case we're going to break the bottom here, and I think that 114 then looks very much like the next stop, right? So if I show you the data here momentarily, you know, if this is a 15-minute chart, right, and I just grabbed the bottom here, this is what we longed off yesterday, and, you know, now we're sitting more or less at resistance again, but, you know, if this was a 15-minute chart, I'd be looking for this, right? Bounce off here, lower high, you know, little dead cat bounce, and then break the bottom, right? And that's not me hating on animals. It's just the that's just the technical term. All right, so, you know, I'm anticipating that same behavior here on this daily chart. Now, the challenge with that is timing your trades on a shorter term, you know, on a more intraday basis, and not getting killed for your efforts. Please note the daily Bollinger Band here curled up underneath price. Maybe we're actually going to go a little bit further here. Maybe we're going to go more towards sort of 125, maybe even as high as sort of 125.30 here. If I show you the 4-hour momentarily, you see what I mean? This shows it even a little more clearly, right? I mean, if I take the Fib of the overall drop here, obviously we've got pretty serious resistance level through, pretty serious resistance level through 125. The figure, you can just go back and see that for yourself, but basically what I'm expecting is a little something like this. Okay, maybe Asia brings us back a little bit, we Fib, continue the move to the long side. So I still think you're going to have one more opportunity to get long during Asia, but then the closer we get to around this 125 to 125.40, then I'm going to look for some hourly and 50-minute rollover to try and take that short and stay in it. Now, here's going to be the challenge, right? I mean, we're not perfect all the time. I'll just take it to the hour, sort of narrowing things down here, and you can tell that we've broken this last few swing highs. So you're gonna catch people trying to long this at the Fib to the upside. I mean, around sort of 124.10 to 124.20, and frankly, I'll look to long there too, right? Because that, you know, that should take us up to that 4-hour resistance level, and then we can look to short, right? So, you know, in a nutshell, looking to get short, then looking to get long, then looking to get sustainably short. Now, this sustainable looking short area is going to be tough to survive because you're going to have a major fight on your hands. All right, you're going to have people trying to short on the 4-hour to the downside, and you're going to have people seeing that daily trend line is holding and are trying to prop this up on the Fib to the long side. All right, so this area here is going to be tough between sort of 125 the figure and 124.50, say. Those 50 pips are going to tell us, 50-60 pips are going to tell us everything we need to know about the yens over the next, heck, I think week, frankly, because if we can break below that, then I think we're going seriously downtown, and especially if we can get some help from the equity markets to back it up. I've noticed that we've got some good correlation returning in the equity markets with the yen. So, you know, that's more or less what I'm looking for on the euro yen, a sort of a short, long, short scenario. Okay, pretty simple stuff. And really, if I take you to the pound, quite similar, right? I mean, this long yesterday, we planned in boot camp off the 52 level. Pretty basic stuff. I mean, it's previous resistance. You add a weekly S2 at the beginning of the market open. I mean, you almost got nowhere to go but up at that point. But here's the thing, all right? If I switch out to the daily very quickly and I take the fib of the overall daily rise, we've come down to this, you know, 38 to 50% area. However, on the 4 hour, it's made a bit of a bearish turn on it. So here comes the fight. I don't think that pound's going to be the best trading pair today. I just get so many requests to look at pound that I almost feel like I'm doing a disservice not to. But, you know, basically, here's how I'm going to play this, is that I think we short through 53.70 area. So I'm going to look for reasons to short there. And I think we probably long through around the 52.70 zone. So I'm going to look to play the long side there and try and be in both ways, break even. You know, try and take the long here, finish the job, then take the short, and then let the big boys sort it out, right? I don't want any real part of trading in the middle of that fib range, right? From the fib to the downside to the fib to the upside. Now, I think that there is a fair possibility, given the 4 hour price action, that we just roll off this and then go down to the next level. That puts us around sort of 51.30, in which case I think we're going to see some longs creep into the market. So, you know, it's not exactly compelling analysis today on this. I mean, basically, I'm looking for these 4 hour shorts here because I think that we can make some lower lows. So I'm looking for, you know, the short side of we could just got a little pop down in the Kiwi yen, but a little short side of the Kiwi yen, you know, the Aussie dollar, or rather Aussie yen, the US yen, the Euro yen, the pound yen. All of them look very much the same, and quite frankly, so does this pound dollar, if you want to know the truth, from around this 53.70 area. So there you have it. All right. Not very complicated analysis, but I hope you got a little something out of it. My name's David Pegler. This has been a look at the European market for April the 20th, 2010. Please leave me some feedback at YouTube, our blog, or on the Bootcamp Facebook, and join me on Twitter, okay? Forex David, that's where you can find me. All right, guys, we'll chat to you later, and good luck further.